Oggi la Chiesa celebra San Marco, uno dei quattro evangelisti.
Today the church celebrates the feast of St. Mark, one of the four evangelists. He was very close to the Apostle Peter. The Mark's Gospel was the first that was written. It's simple, it has a simple style. Very close. If today you have a bit of time, take it in hand and read it. It's not that long. But it's pleasing to read the simplicity with which Mark recounts the life of the Lord. And in the Gospel, which is the end of Mark's Gospel that we just read, there's the sending forth by the Lord. The Lord revealed himself as Savior, as the only Son of God. He revealed himself to all of Israel, to the people, and especially with more details to the apostles, to the disciples.
Questo è il congedo del Signore.
This is the Lord taking leave. He leaves.
Partì e fu elevato in cielo e sedette alla destra di Dio.
He was taken up into heaven and took his seat at the right hand of God. Before leaving, he appeared to the 11 and said to them, "Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature." This is the missionality of the church. Either the faith has a missionary dimension or it's not faith. Faith is not something only for myself, so that I might grow in faith. This is a Gnostic heresy. Faith always brings you to go out of yourself, to go out. The transmission of the faith is transmitted. It's something we offer. Above all, through witness. Go and so that the people see how you live. Someone once said, a European priest from a European city said to me, there's a lot of unbelief, a lot of Gnosticism in our city. Because the Christians do not have faith. If they had it, they would certainly give it to the people.
Manca la missionarietà perché?
They lack this missional dimension because their roots are missing. The conviction. Oh, sure, I'm a Christian, I'm a Catholic. As if it were a social habit. On my identity card, I'm called this and this, and I'm a Christian. Oh, okay. It's one of the facts on the identity card. This is a cultural thing. Faith is necessarily something that brings you out. It brings you to give it, to transmit it sincerely. It's not something that's quiet. Oh, I'd like to say, you mean to say that we all need to be missionaries, we need to go to far-off countries? No, that's a part of the missional dimension, missionary dimension. It means that if you have faith, you necessarily need to go out of yourself. You need to go out of yourself and show it in society, your faith. That's a social faith. It's for everyone. Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. This doesn't mean to become someone who proselytizes others, as if you're recruiting people on a soccer team, or if you're a nonprofit organization. It's that you show the revelation so that the Holy Spirit can work in people. Our witness is through service. Service is a way of living. If I say that I am a Christian but I live like a pagan, that doesn't work. That doesn't convince anybody. If I say that I'm a Christian and I live as a Christian, if I live like a Christian, that attracts. That's testimony, witness. One time a university student asked me in Poland, he asked me, well, in the university I have many atheistic companions. What do I need to say to convince them? Nothing. The last thing you need to do is say something. Start to live it. And they, by seeing your witness, will attract them. And they'll ask you, why do you live that way? Faith is transmitted, but not by convincing, but by offering a treasure. It's there. See it, observe it, and this is also humility, the humility that Peter spoke of in the first reading. Clothe yourselves with humility in your dealings with one another, because God opposes the proud and bestows grace on the humble. How many times in the church, in the church's history, movements have been born men and women who wanted to convince others and convert others, and were real proselytes. They ended up in corruption. This part of the gospel is very tender. But where is the certainty? How can we be sure that by going out of myself, I will be fruitful in the transmission of the faith?
Proclamate il Vangelo ad ogni creatura.
Proclaim the gospel to every creature.
Farete meraviglie.
You will do wonders.
Il Signore sarà con noi.
And the Lord will be with us until the end of the world. He accompanies us. In the transmission of the faith, the Lord is always with us. In the transmission of ideology, there are teachers, but when I act out of faith, the Lord is there accompanying me. I am never alone in the transmission of the faith. It's the Lord in me who transmits the faith. This is a promise. I will be with you all days, even till the end of the world. Let's pray to the Lord that He might help us to live our faith like this, a faith that has open doors, open arms, a transparent faith. Not a faith that proselytizes, but a faith that says, look, I'm this way. And through this healthy curiosity, others are helped to accept this message that will save them.